case briefs, and so much more. LSData's got what you're looking for.
In 2002, the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey, along with one of its subsidiaries, filed a lawsuit against several insurance companies for damages resulting from the presence of friable asbestos in their buildings. They claimed that physical damage occurred due to the presence of asbestos and the threat of it being released into the air, causing harm to human health. However, the district court ruled that the Port Authority needed to prove physical damage to their structures to trigger coverage, and that the plaintiffs couldn't provide sufficient evidence of this to survive summary judgment. The Port Authority appealed, arguing that the district court used an incorrect standard for physical loss and misinterpreted insurance case law. The United States Court of Appeals for the Third Circuit heard the case, Port Authority versus Affiliated FM Insurance, which focused on the idea that for insurance coverage to be triggered, proof of physical damage is required, necessitating a distinct, demonstrable, and physical alteration of a building's structure. The appeals court ultimately upheld the district court's decision, as the plaintiffs didn't provide enough evidence of physical loss or damage from asbestos contamination for coverage under their all-risks policy. The court stated that the mere presence of asbestos or the possibility of its future release is not enough to establish a physical loss or damage. Rather, the contamination had to make the structure uninhabitable or unusable. The plaintiff's buildings had contained asbestos for many years without any interruption in use, further demonstrating that their claim was not valid.
Case briefs and so much more. LSData's got what you're looking for. Visit LSD.law, elevate your mind. Leave the stress of class.